Forseti Bæstjórnar, rektor Háskólans á Akureyri, Dr. Young, Dr. Ma, Captain, moderators, thank you, August, for your kind words, introduction. I would like to say some words about China-Iceland Arctic Science Cooperation. I will begin with going over Iceland's Arctic policy in some respect, and then I will introduce the status of China-Iceland cooperation as it is now. As you all know, but sometimes it's not practiced here in Iceland, Iceland is a country located in the Arctic, and it's on an oceanic crossroads, and you can see the northeastern passage with Shulong came, and then Shulong will go back straight to the north to Shanghai. These future shipping routes may be of high importance for whole Iceland, and especially North and East Iceland. And as a coastal state in the Arctic, Iceland has a strong economic and ecological and political connections to the Arctic region. The Iceland Arctic policy is based on principles of sustainable development, and Iceland's Arctic policy was approved by the Althingi a little more than 1 year ago. As Iceland as an Arctic coastal state has its land and vast marine areas within the Arctic, and the economic livelihood is interlinked with Arctic resources, fishing, energy and tourism. You see that around Iceland are some of the most important currents, which also are the one of the bases for the global conveyor belt, which has a special role in the climate of the planet. And Steingrímur Jónsson from the University of Akureyri, he can tell you more about that. There are profound challenges facing Iceland in the Arctic, these things cannot be solved by any one country. So it's important to build partnerships and agreements with both in the Arctic and outside the Arctic. And therefore the visit to Shulong is of such a great importance here. And it is the Icelandic government is committed to build Iceland as a center of international center of Arctic activities, and especially here in Akureyri, the top photography of the campus of the University of Akureyri, where Stern Pneumatic Institute and Kraft and Pane are located. And there is as August mentioned, there is an international Arctic, there is an Arctic network being established here in Akureyri with the Arctic related institution that will hopefully reach for all Arctic related institutions in Iceland and abroad. The most important forum for circular polar cooperation is the Arctic Council, which Iceland chaired from 2002 to 2004. And as has already been said, two Arctic Council working groups are hosted here in Akureyri, the CAF and PAME. There is a growing political importance of the Arctic Council. There is now the permanent secretariat going to be established in Tromsø, Norway, and the work of the Arctic Council is moving from policy shaping to policy making, and we can take the search and rescue agreement as an example of that. Turning to international R&D cooperation, first and foremost is the International Arctic Science Committee. Icelandic scientists, they participate in all five IS working groups: atmosphere, cryosphere, human and social, marine and terrestrial. And I'm very pleased that two excellent scientists from University of Akureyri and Stern Institute are represented in the IS group, Steingrimur Jónsson from University of Akureyri and the Marine Science Institute, and Johan Nieman Larsen from Stefansson Arctic Institute is a representative in the human social. And then we have the Nordic Council Top Level Research Initiative. There are more than 20 Icelandic scientists active in that scientific cooperation. We have the big R&D programs of the European Union. The biggest one is probably Connecting Climate Knowledge for Europe. I have mentioned the Arctic Council working groups, which are performing research for policy making. We have the bilateral cooperation with France, Norway, and USA, and many more countries. We have recently established our cooperation with China. We have the China-Iceland Framework Agreement on Arctic Cooperation, Memorandum of Understanding on Marine and Polar Science between the State Oceanic Administration of China and the Ministry of Foreign Affairs in Iceland. We have the China-Iceland Joint Aurora Observatories, observatory we will hear later from Hongqiao, Professor Hongqiao, the plans for that, and last but not least, the historical Shulong Arctic Expedition. The MOU or study in between the Polar Research Institute of China and the Asiatic Center of Research was signed last Friday at Shulwang's visit to Reykjavik, and this memorandum of understanding is also open to Arctic related institutions in Iceland. The main parts of this memorandum is that Rannís will support and advise the Polar Research Institute on the idea of establishing China Nordic Arctic Research Center in Shanghai. The cooperation may include separate collaborative research projects, take turns to hold meetings, scholar visit, exchange of information and materials, and reports. The main features of the research cooperation may include, but is not limited to, adaptation to climate change and sustainable development, economic cooperation between Asian and Nordic countries, Arctic strategy, policy and legislation. And the first China-Nordic Arctic Cooperation Research Seminar is set to convene in Shanghai in 2013. The Polar Research Institute in Shanghai will bring with them Polar Network of Strategy Research, which consists of institutes and universities. You see the names here: Fudan University, Chongqing University, Wuhan, Fujian University of China, East China University of Political Science and Law, and then four universities in Shanghai. And many of these universities are one of the best universities in China. So this is a very preeminent network of researchers. We are hoping that the Icelandic Partners institutions will be the, besides Rannís, the Stefánsson Arctic Institute, University of Iceland, University of Akureyri, Polar Law Institute, the Icelandic Maritime Authority, Icelandic Marine Research Institute, the Met Office, Icelandic Institute of Natural History, Arctic Portal, and Climate Research Fund. Before I close, I want just to tell you, give you a short historical perspective of the China-Iceland Arctic Science Cooperation. Because this has rather short, we have come a long way, but this is a rather short history. A Chinese Arctic Science Delegation visited both Reykjavik and Akureyri in August 2011, Dr. Yang was a part of this delegation, and during this visit we had the first China-Iceland Arctic Symposium in Reykjavik, during this visit the ideas discussed were joint Aurora Observatory in Iceland, increased emphasis on cooperation in social sciences, and possibilities of Shulong visiting Iceland were also touched upon. In April 2012, a delegation from Polar Research Institute, including Dr. Yang and Professor Hong Xiao, visited Iceland, and we discussed further the joint Aurora Observatory and possible visit of Shulong to Iceland. The two agreements, framework agreement on cooperation and memorandum of understanding or marine and polar science between State Oceanic Administration and Ministry of Foreign Affairs. They were signed during the Premier of China visit to Iceland the same year. And in June, a delegation from Iceland was invited by the Polar Research Institute to Shanghai and Peking to assist with the planning of Sulong's visit to Iceland. There were ideas of the Aurora Observatory and prepared MOU between Ramis and PRC. So you see, during this year, we have come a long way in this cooperation, and I am very grateful for the sort of the commitment and trust the Chinese the people from PRC and SOA and CAA have put in our Icelandic partners. But just to conclude, as you have seen and know, Iceland is ideally located to conduct many kinds of research. Icelandic scientists have much to contribute in Arctic research as a laboratory for Arctic research. China and Iceland are facing many common challenges in relation to Arctic research, and it is important that direct links and joint projects have been developed between scientists from China and Iceland. Ramis will do its best to facilitate such cooperation, and the joint Chinese-Icelandic Aurora Observatory in Iceland, Sulong Arctic Expedition, and future China Nordic Arctic Research Center are extremely important steps in this progress. So, thank you.